share with you why we have created a game. Games are excellent sources of entertainment. They are good for spending leisure time and building mind refreshers. Games are good for good exercise for mind, for both for the developers as well as for the players. And of course, a game is a cherry on cake or a game edit, and a game serves this purpose well. Technical support. Our game supports the game runs on Java enabled handsets and is independent of any hardware, special hardware or software requirements. Okay. Now, introduction to our game. The game derives its name from the Rattler Snake. The game has 10 levels. The player snake has 3 lives, and each food contributes to 10 points. Bonus points are calculated on minimum number of steps taken. Each level has a different scenario, and with difficulty grows with increasing levels. Snake promotes to the next level on eating 24 items.
So let us start with the game. The first level comes. In the first level, we are giving a general. In the first level, we are giving a general introduction about our game. So what will be the color of our snake so that the player gets used to its environment. In the first level, our game basically comprises of a simple snake and the food eating. So if snake collides with itself, it will die and will lose on life. So basically, but here the player will get used to the environment of the game. And for going to the next level, it will have to eat 20 items and then it will proceed to the next level. In the next level we have used a simple AI for our food moving. The food moves as we move towards it. There is a particular situation only in which we can eat food. So we have to find that particular situation in which we can eat food. That will be the choice of the player. In the third, there are some barriers which a particular scenario which we have to pass to get our success and to get our food. If we collide with that barrier, we will lose one of our lives. Next level is icy level. In this level, if we go on the particular grids that are represented in the sky blue color, the snake will slide to the another part or to another grid. Then comes our next level, fighting, which there is a thief snake. This name, by the name, it's clear that the other snake is trying to steal our food. And so we have to go and eat first, then that snake. If it does other snake, our life will be lost. Then comes level 6. In level 6, the barriers which were presented in the earlier level now starts moving in the particular positions. We have to be aware of them and then get out of them. In the level 7, there is one enemy snake and the moving walls. So we have to be sure that we eat first and faster. In the level 8, there will be a moving snake and thief. In the 9th level, there are 3 snakes. Out of these 2 snakes will be moving random with their own AI, and another snake will be thief snake, which will be trying to eat us or food. So we have to be aware of that and to save ourselves from that. The last level is double total trouble, in which there is an enemy snake, walls, and another snake, a thief snake, which try to eat food. This is the last level of our game. To win it, we have to be sure that we don't lose our life, and we have to also be sure that we are going to eat 220 items first than the other enemy snake does. So if it doesn't happen and another snake eats 20 objects, then our game is going to be stopped there and we are going to lose.
Our game has a scope of Bluetooth extension and increasing the difficulty of levels. Now we would like to share what we have learned through while developing this game and through all our training here. What we have learned is dedication and hard work leads to success. We have improved our programming concepts and our minds that have been sitting for long have now started crawling.
Questions. Okay, the first question is, What were your main programming challenges while you were doing it?
Main programming challenges are basically to get used to the JVM environment, as we have not worked with this environment earlier. So the main challenge was to get used to that environment and then what we're going to get. Then came the AI, basically that comes with our.
Within the code. Okay, how long did you take to, Kartika, how long did you take to overcome the first obstacle of understanding the J2ME environment?
About
a week. After that you were comfortable? Now if I tell you to make something else within that framework, can you do it fast? Okay. What did you learn about AI?
AI is basically artificial intelligence. So in our computer, in our program, when we say AI, it is basically calculations of the numerics which the computer does and work on that.
So what's the prime example of AI in your game?
In our game, there are basically three examples of AI. First, where the food moves as we go, as we approach the food from the same row, same column, the food start moving and we can't eat that. There comes the basic introduction to the AI. Then the next level comes where ball starts moving. They are moving to a particular level and then moves back. That's another example of AI. And the third and most important is the AI of the snake. There the enemy snake moves and eats food itself and takes its own decision. Like the same AI goes with the killer snake, where its target rather than food is snake, ourselves.
So you have two enemy snakes, one of them is going after the food,
awesome.
Another one is going after you,
yes.
And the third one is doing what?
That's another level, sir.
Okay.
In that level, there are three snakes. Two snakes making random movement.
Okay.
They are not considering any our food,
okay,
or not ourselves. They are just making movements in the field, and one snake is going behind our food.
How was your experience while designing the levels?
It was very good. It gave us a chance to think what we can do and to make it happen.
Make more imaginative.
More
questions.
Do you use different AI for every level?
AI comes according to what we want from the different level. Like
for every level you use different AI. Or in the same AI you have done some modifications.
We have done in the same AI, but each level, like in the food level, food. So there will be different AI for moving the food. For same for balls, we want to move balls. There will be different AI. But like there will joint, there was a joint.
AI for snakes.
Snakes.
Snake and thief snake
just minor changes. Just minor changes. And there were some levels in which we have to use both AIs, like for killer snake, thief snake, and for balls. That comes common from the behind. We just inherited now that particular.
Random snake can't move that.
They are just moving around the grid, taking their movement.
But can you please explain the AI for moving snake around the
screen? AI for moving snake is just easy. We are moving it according to.
Okay.
We are moving our AI snake just according to the food. This, there is no movement, they are just changing the grid. There is a grid. Positions in the grid are changing. So we see it as a movement, but it is not a movement. Only the grid are changing their movement for the food. Food is its target, it will be making it. It wants to eat food. So it will be making movements according to that particular system that it has to eat food. And if the food changes its position, then AI will change and it will take a secondary for it.
Okay, okay.